How often do you find yourself in the middle of a chess game, and when it's your turn to move, you have no idea what to play? Can you find a two-move plan that improves the bishop and attacks the knight on f3? By asking that question, you may have found the strange-looking, but powerful move, bishop e8. Black's plan is now clear. The bishop is going to move to h5 on the next move, improving one of Black's less effective pieces and attacking one of White's most important pieces in the battle for the center, the knight on f3. After rook f to e1, and bishop h5, Black attacks the knight, pinning it to the rook on d1. Black is now threatening to capture the knight and win the pawn on d4 by removing one of its key defenders. White responded to this threat by playing bishop e2, protecting the knight and clearing the d-file for White's queen and rook to help protect the d4 pawn. Now that the light squared bishop has been improved, what should Black do next? How can we continue with our plan to add more pressure to the d4 square? Can you improve a piece that isn't doing that much and add more pressure to the d4 target? If you felt the knight on e7 isn't very effective right now, great job! Black brings the knight into action and supports the plan to attack d4 with knight f5. Move by move, Black is focused on improving pieces that weren't very effective and now has a comfortable position with all of the minor pieces working together to put pressure on the key d4 square. Black was able to convert this comfortable position into victory. Let's take a look at another example. In this position, both sides once again are fighting for control of the d4 square. White played the strange-looking move bishop d3, attacking Black's bishop and also blocking the queen's protection of the d4 pawn. Before thinking about a plan, we have to check for tactics. Why can't Black just win a pawn with knight takes d4? If we can't answer that question, we should accept our opponent's gift. Can you see White's trick? After knight takes d4, knight takes d4, queen takes d4. White has lured the queen to the d4 square, and now that it is unprotected, White wins the queen by using the discovered attack, bishop b5 check, checking Black's king and revealing White's queen's attack on the black queen. Now that we understand that capturing the d4 pawn is a disaster for Black, we need to come up with a plan. White's king is already committed to the kingside, and Black's king still has a choice. One plan is to play safely and capture White's bishop, and then castle kingside. This would be a solid choice, but can we find a more active plan? All of Black's minor pieces are developed, and Black has developed the queen to an active square on d6. Can you think of a more aggressive way to bring Black's king to safety, and plan to attack White's kingside? That's right, Black can castle queenside. Now that Black has castled queenside, knight takes d4 is a threat because White's bishop can no longer check the black king. Did Black's decision to castle queenside create a clear plan? When you castle on opposite sides of the board, both sides should try to attack as forcefully as possible against the enemy king. Notice Black allows White to trade bishops and double Black's pawns on the f-file because Black welcomes another pawn into the attack to help open up lines against White's king. After knight e2, protecting the d4 pawn, how can Black begin to set up threats against White's kingside and start an attack? If you found g5, great job! The h3 pawn is a hook in White's position that Black will try to rip open to start an attack. White's pieces are not as actively developed and are not yet prepared to attack on the queenside. White should have played bishop takes f5 with the idea of moving the queen to d3, attacking the f5 pawn, trying to catch up on development, and slow down Black's attack. But in the game, White played c3, adding more protection to the d4 pawn and preparing b4 to start a queenside attack. But Black's attack crashes through first with g4, attacking the knight on f3 and the pawn on h3, so Black will be able to open lines on the next move. By castling queenside, Black forced both sides to focus on the plan of attacking on opposite wings. Since Black's pieces were better developed and prepared for this plan, Black was able to gain an advantage and later won the game.